What is up, Rocket League people? Hope you're all doing well. I don't want to sound like a pansy or a wimp here, okay? I want to leave a warning out there for the future of Rocket League pros. I don't know what they're doing when they come time for trolling new cars out there. If you guys watched RLCS Week 1, we saw Flakes actually win a game with the Scarab, and now we actually have other pros out there taking to other events to troll with new cars. Let me just preface by saying there was not much on the line here, so I'm not too worried about it, but when it comes time for other events out there and seeing more and more pros try and potentially troll with new cars, it almost gets a bit worrisome, only because I've covered stories on here about Fortnite pros doing similar things. They go to third-party events, there's not much on the line, they kind of joke around. The pros that we talked about in Fortnite were actually stream sniping because it was, you know, not a top-tier event, so obviously not much to lose at all. I don't want Rocket League to go down that path. I don't think they will. Let me clarify that, but if you guys did catch it this past couple of days, it was actually Star Circuit qualifier number 4. I believe 8 qualifiers throughout the entire event, with eventually $30,000 in prize pools, and the teams also accrue points throughout the entire, all the qualifiers as well. And of course, at the very end, the 2 top teams, they get their buys in the finals. The other 6 teams, they have to play it out like a regular playoff bracket. We have 2 teams that are pretty far ahead. That's going to be Space Station alongside Ghost, who were trolling in the finals of this past qualifier. So for anyone out there who was worried, you know, why are we seeing this? They are so far ahead. There's not really technically anything on the line. If this were an actual like a DreamHack event and we have pros trolling, I would be a bit worried then. I just don't want it to go down that route. It's just very weird to see all of a sudden we got Flakes do it this past weekend, and now we have at least 2 or 3 other pros throughout the event, and especially in the grand finals, when again nothing was on the line. They troll around with you know, the Ghost car and also the Scarab again, and so it's weird to see. And again, it's also a weird point in time because you love to see pros try new things, and part of me also wants to see this kind of stuff in RLCS, but then the other side of me is like, no, you don't want to see that. RLCS is very serious. So what are you guys' thoughts on this? Of course, when it comes time for Star Circuit, I just hope they don't mind. And again, not much was lost here. Not much was on the line for those 2 teams who are very far ahead in the point standings. I'll keep you guys updated, okay, in the coming weeks, especially with events outside of RLCS, what these pros are doing, and do we have a new meta for cars coming, especially when it comes to the Scarab? I don't know. Probably not. We'll see. Now, other news out there as well. We actually talk about my number one villain as we try and dip and dive into personalities out there, which I do think are certainly developing in Rocket League. Compared to Call of Duty, there's not much there because Call of Duty is just so dominant when it comes to personalities and drama. There's not too many villains of personalities yet, at least of the evil kind, I would say, in Rocket League. One of my top ones and favorite ones has to be Rapid, though, currently from Team Flight. If you guys did see, they dropped their opening series to Pittsburgh this past weekend. In doing so, not even a bit of drama out of that. But of course, when it comes time for the former lineup, that being for RBG, comes time for that drama, right? We know the Aeon kicking after they qualified for RLCS. That trio eventually goes on to Flight, and a guy like Rapid stays. And I think it's a bit of a weird circumstance because he actually posted a YouTube video not too long ago as well, you know, playing with Aeon and how they were vibing together, and they are still friends. They did not end on bad terms. It kind of reinforces for the negativity out there as well going towards Rapid Way, which certainly there's a lot of it, right? There's a lot of controversial characters in Rocket League. I would say he's one of the top ones as well, based off the way he acts sometimes. And a lot of people were left thinking that, okay, why would you remove Aeon? Even though we've actually figured out and confirmed, guys, it was as much Aeon's choice as anyone else's. You know, he chose not to be with this team for RLCS and going forward, you know, so I don't place blame on that roster for removing him because he also made that choice. We have now confirmed that, but it does make it hard for any fans out there who do not know that. And then they see clips out there of Rapid also trolling in scrims. You know, you kick Aeon for not being motivated, but then you troll around in your practice time. So I understand where both sides are coming from, but a bit of a reinforcement here as well. And again, to show you guys, these players are still friends. And yes, it was as much Aeon's choice as anyone else's. So Rapid, you keep doing you. Stir up some drama for me. I'll make sure to cover it this next weekend as we head into weekend number 2. Speaking of which, a bit of a change up for a lot roster out there who likely we won't see BC in the field. But I was a bit concerned this past weekend with Spoodah. He went blacked out on his Twitter, of course, posted a bit of a trolley and obviously joking post about ending his competitive Rocket League career. Although he was not joking about not being in Rival Series, he has now been signed to the Soniqs. I thought it was actually pretty cool. Speaking of personality, certainly one is this guy. I mean, he can start a copypasta on Reddit in a matter of seconds, so I love the character. Here is their announcement video. The Soniqs, by the way, a very, very impressive opening loss. I know I don't usually say that. Game 5 NRG, I was very impressed. They have now signed their hard carry in Spoodah.
Tired of dumb mistakes? Looking for that RLCS hard carry? definitely don't want these gentlemen. Aren't you tired of watching bad reads?
Oh, no, 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 no.
Oh, I'm lit.
Missed open nets.
Hey, I just missed an open net.
Guys, get your pog champs ready, all right? Oh my god! No way. Dude, I can't believe I just did that.
As always, hope you guys all enjoy the Rocket League news. My DMs are always open for all you Rocket League fans out there. I'm still trying to get the ball rolling, how to cover this stuff for all of you, but I'm certainly enjoying it at the very, very least. Hope you guys all enjoy. Until next time, drink your coffee. I'll be back here all day long breaking down esports and gaming news. Until next time, take care. Bye-bye.